This video is sponsored by Jacobs Vehicle Systems. Visit jacobsvehiclesystems.com for more information.
They say your trucks have too many emissions when they call. Eddie takes care of them all. Just place Eddie inside the truck, and Eddie will take care of all those dirty emissions and the fuel economy. Holy cow! Well, Eddie doesn't actually do anything for fuel economy, but who cares? Eddie will make those emissions wish they were never alive for just $19.95. We accept cash, money order, MasterCard, Visa, Discover. You know what? Plants are great. I have nothing against plants. I love plants, but a plant in your truck to meet emission standards? Come on. I think we're going to need better technology than that. Thankfully, I think we've got some ideas. In November 2018, the EPA announced the need to update nitrogen oxide emission standards in heavy-duty trucks with its Cleaner Trucks Initiative. According to the initiative's overview found at epa.gov, heavy-duty vehicles are the largest contributor to mobile source emissions of nitrogen oxide, and they are expected to be one of the largest mobile source contributors to ozone going into 2025. That means even though from 2007 to 2017, nitrogen oxide emissions in the U.S. dropped by more than 40%, there is still work to be done. So we can expect to see tightened emissions regulations on the horizon, and these new regulations could put a greater focus on measuring real-world driving conditions. For example, the California Air Resources Board is scheduled to tighten regulations to set new limits on nitrogen oxide, one of the precursors to smog. This will require that new trucks that use fossil fuels include the most effective exhaust control technology. As a result, we're starting to see some really interesting technology sprout up, focused on both lowering emissions and bettering fuel economy. One of these is called Cylinder Deactivation Technology, developed by Jacobs Vehicle Systems along with some of their OEM partners. Cylinder Deactivation Technology uses the engine's valve train to optimize thermal management within the engine. Jacobs says that this approach gets the system hot faster and keeps it hot, which allows for further simplification of the aftertreatment systems. It works like this. Cylinder deactivation technology turns off the intake and exhaust main vents and combines that with turning off injection to shut down the entire cylinder. This can essentially turn a six-cylinder engine into a three-cylinder engine, for example. By making the active cylinders work harder, heat is increased, which benefits the aftertreatment systems working to reduce nitrogen oxide. The increased heat levels help the aftertreatment systems to convert the nitrogen oxide into less harmful gases and get rid of the pollutants quicker in that cycle. To help us understand just how effective this technology can be and what this means for fleets, Fleet Equipment's editor Jason Morgan spoke with Rob Janik, Director of New Technology at Jacobs Vehicle Systems, about cylinder deactivation technology in July of 2020. Here's what Rob had to say.
The product release that you put out here had really a jaw-dropping figure in terms of fuel consumption. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? What is the the stat noted was that potentially up to 25% fuel consumption reduction. Is that accurate?
That was inaccurate. That was reported in that the Tula Cummins paper at the Vienna symposium. So that's the paper that was released. That 25% point was a specific operating point. So it was a low load condition.
Right.
So it's sitting maybe at an idle condition with a very low firing density. So basically one cylinder firing randomly in a sequence to keep the engine running. So yes, that's what you can realize with that fixed mode. How does that translate into road miles is maybe the next question. I think that's what we're all looking to do. So we've already started deploying some of these cylinder deactivations into trucks. So we're looking to get truck experience. That dynamic one, that's planned to go in a truck. So we'll see how that's going to come out in the next year or so. But that's the whole goal, is to find out what the drivers are going to be able to see on the road and what the fleets will be able to see for fuel savings.
Rob says Jacobs hopes that this technology will be able to work hand in hand with electrification technologies coming into the heavy duty truck marketplace. Here he is from that same interview with Jason on why this technology will continue to be important even as electrification evolves.
you know, you always kind of wonder how much more efficient, how cleaner can diesel engine technology get, especially as we're looking at electric trucks coming in the market, a lot of push there. You mentioned the emissions and the regulation that's going on there. I mean, this could really help impact that tremendously as well.
Yeah, no, we really appreciate the understand the move to the market, maybe to look at electrified vehicles. But at the same side, we believe that the heavy duty diesel has an extreme, there's an extreme need for the heavy duty diesel engine. And we don't see the need drying up in the next 20, 30 years. Mm-hmm. The power density, the range, the performance of a heavy duty diesel engine is key to how we move freight. And I think all the advancements that the market and engineering groups like us and our OEs have all shown that we can meet these ultra low emissions that the market's looking for, and that the customer's looking for, and that regulators are looking for. And we feel that we can fill those needs and be very carbon aware and trying to make the diesel last as long as it's feasible.
To watch the full interview with Rob, visit fleetequipmentmag.com and search Diesel Engine Cylinder Deactivation Deep Dive. Thanks for watching.